The Dreamspeakers Film Festival kicks off tomorrow, and today Executive Director Helen Calahasen is here to tell us more, along with Lese Skidmore, who has a film screening at the festival. So thank you both for coming in today.
Thanks for having us.
Yes, so tell us about the Dreamspeakers Film Festival.
Well, it happens, or it starts June 1st to the 4th, and we have many things that are happening. Of course, the films that are being shown starting tomorrow night, we have a great opening night film that is a comedy based out of New Zealand. Excellent show to come to, along with other excellent shows that we're showing, everything from dramas, docudramas, music videos, to documentaries, and they're from around the world, so that's always nice. But we also have local flavor here as well.
Fantastic. That was my question. I was thinking local when you said New Zealand. This really is an international film festival.
Yes, it is.
And so, Lise, you have a film that is showing here. We do have a piece of the film to look at, so why don't we look at that first, and then you can tell us about
it. Sure. Yeah.
Things do not sink in all the time until, like, later on.
I'd read something, and I wouldn't remember what I read. I'd read the bottom line before the top line. So I knew there was something wrong there.
Fetal alcohol spectrum disorder is an organic brain damage resulting from a woman drinking during her pregnancy.
So that film called Invisible, and Lise, tell us, what is it about and what compelled you to make that film?
The film's about best practices for working with individuals who have FASD when they come in conflict with the law. And I guess what inspired it was the fact that clients at Native Counseling Services and Bear Paw Media Productions produces videos for Native Counseling Services. Their clients, some of them have FASD, and we wanted to make a resource that would be utilized for our clients. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So your film, obviously one of the more serious ones of the festival.
Yeah.
But there's all different types.
Absolutely. As I said, there is comedies, there's docudramas, lots of good films that are showcased this year. And, you know, some of the more interesting ones are environmentally based as well. We have a lot of those. They're forefront issues with the Aboriginal community. So we like to show those kind of films as well.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So are these beginning filmmakers or people who have been at it forever, or a mix of both?
Mix of both, because we do also have a Dreamspeakers on Tour project where we have Aboriginal youth that take part in this part of the festival as well, and their shows are shown to their peers, and they're judged by those peers to win some cash prizes for their films. So we have the very beginning filmmakers to the very experienced ones, and as I said, tomorrow's film is an Oscar-based or Oscar-nominated filmmaker from different previous works that he's had, and they're just great films to show.
Fantastic. So as a filmmaker, how do you, leading up to the festival, do you get nervous or do you get excited, or what's it like for you?
I do. I get nervous, but that's just me. I'm sure not everybody does, but it's exciting to be in a film festival. This is our first one in this film festival, so.
Fantastic. Yeah. And you get to be with an Oscar-nominated director, so there you go. Okay, so we do actually have a couple of tickets to give away for the festival. To win those, we'll start with the phone number, 486-9233, or out of town, 1-877-486-2376. So it runs from the 1st into the 4th, different venues all across the city, and if you want to find out more about where you can see it all, you can go to our website and then find the link from there. So thank you so much for coming, and good luck with your showing.
Thanks for having us.